Hey everybody, how's it going today? Hope you're all having a great weekend. Well, I haven't done a TSNP update in a couple of days, so I just wanted to give you my thoughts on the current price action. Plus, I want to go over a couple other nice looking low price stocks that could offer some good trading opportunities for next week. Now, if you're new to my channel, I like to find short-term and long-term trading and investing opportunities in typically lower-priced stocks. I like to find undervalued stocks with high growth potential and talk about all other things finance-related as well. If that's something that interests you, please consider subscribing so you don't miss any future trading or investing ideas. But please remember, I am not a financial advisor, so please do all of your own research before investing in any of these stocks. All right, well, let's get right into the charts. This is the daily chart of Tesoro Enterprises. And as we can see, Friday was basically a non-event. It went absolutely nowhere. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 days in a row where it went practically nowhere. I mean, this chart is defying the laws of probability as far as moving after a big move up. So this is very unusual. I can't even remember the last time I seen a stock that was this volatile, just have all the volatility just get sucked right out of it. It just starts going sideways, and we have found a complete equilibrium of buyers and sellers right now. I think a lot of the traders like me have probably moved on to something else, and a lot of people that are holding this stock right now are probably long-term holds because there is just no big buying or big selling coming in. You know, we look down here and the volume is just bone dry. It's drying up everywhere. And if we got a big surge in buying, we got another big volume day, it would probably send this thing to a new relative high past 23 cents for sure, I would think. Or if we had another big wave of selling above above average selling, I should say, would probably send it back down to this 50-day simple moving average right around 10 cents pretty easily. So I think just a lot of the traders have moved out of this market. But you know what they say about consolidations? The longer they go sideways, the bigger the move up or down. So if this thing goes sideways for even just another week or so and another positive catalyst comes into this stock, I mean, that could be enough to really send this thing up. So I think Tesoro Enterprises, I mean, it's continuing to set up. I said this last time, but it's just continuing to set up for a big move up or down. And your guess is as good as mine right now. I would imagine it's probably going to be up just because this thing has had plenty of opportunities to sell off. And it just seems like there's nobody eager to get out of it. So let's take a look at the daily chart real quick, or the intraday chart on this really quick. All right, well, moving over to the 15-minute chart, you can see just how boring this sideways move has become. I mean, it's basically stayed in this tight box, you know, for 8 days in a row, with the low being right around 14 cents, a little above 14 cents, and the high being just above 17 cents. And that's a pretty tight range compared to how this stock has been moving. But, I mean, I wouldn't be a bit surprised if the length of this consolidation, you know, if I had software that could turn it up or turn it down, that would probably be the size of the move coming out of this consolidation. And the longer it goes sideways, probably the bigger move up or down that is going to become. But just more of the same with Tesoro Enterprises. If you're still holding this stock, I mean, there's no reason to be worried about it at this point. And certainly the fact that it's not selling off, that is an extremely good sign for the long-term uptrend of the stock, because the longer it continues to not sell off, the higher the chances are it is going to find another leg up. But those are my current thoughts on Tesoro Enterprises. Let me show you a few other opportunities that I'm seeing in the market right now. All right, well, the first one I want to show you is Fans Unite Entertainment, ticker symbol FUNFF. But before I get started, if you have not subscribed to the channel, I've been trading low-price stocks for many, many years. And I know the penny stocks are red hot right now. Everybody is piling into them, but eventually that's going to, you know, filter out of these stocks. But if you like to trade these lower price stocks, make sure you subscribe to the channel, because I put out videos like this every single week with nice looking charts on lower price stocks. So once all the crowd piles out of the penny stocks, I'm still going to be here finding opportunities every single week, and I'll show you how I like to trade them in these videos as well. So you can learn some technical analysis along the way. But getting back to the chart, Fans Unite Entertainment had a pretty nice move in the latter half of December, and if this one got away from you before you could get in, now is the time to buy in, because it's pulling back into support. You usually don't want to be chasing stocks. I know in this market, stocks have been going absolutely crazy, so when they're extended, a lot of people are being rewarded when they're buying them when they are extended, because they are continuing to scream up in some cases. But that is going to build some poor habits, so just try not to get into the habit of chasing these extended stocks. You know, try to get them on the pullback, and that will increase your odds of success, you know, because when these stocks are red hot and they're pulling back, chances are they're probably going to make a new high. So this is the safe area where you want to be entering. But let's look at the intraday chart so I can show you why this level that it's currently at looks so good. All right, well, jumping over to the 15-minute chart, you can see this is a nice, healthy-looking pullback. It has broken all these moving averages at the moment, but that is not necessarily a terrible thing for the uptrend. I mean, obviously, if it breaks probably into the mid 50 cent range, that means that this breakout is has failed, and you just want to probably move on to another opportunity. That is if you're not a long-term believer in this stock. If you're a long-term believer in this stock, then there's no need to be jumping out of the stock just yet. But if we look at the support levels that it's at right now, it's already had a little bit of a bounce yesterday, but I wouldn't be a bit surprised if it pulls back into this support area and gives all of us another chance to buy this stock in the mid-60s. And in my opinion, that'll be a decent pullback from 95 cents, and I think that this uptrend is still healthy, so that would be my safe area of entering into this stock if I wanted to play the next move up. Hasn't pulled back to the mid-60s just yet, so I'm still waiting for it. But I think FUNF will present a very nice swing trade opportunity. Or if you want to just add to your position for the long term, you know, you want to add on the pullbacks as well when you get the opportunities. So that is my thoughts on FUNF. I think it's a fantastic trade setting up for next week potentially. All right, everybody, the next one I want to show you is LKCO. If you haven't been following my channel, I love these nice long bases before a stock takes off. I think that increases the chance of these stocks getting into nice long uptrends by a lot. So if you look for these long consolidations before one of these penny stocks or these lower price stocks start moving higher, I think that greatly increases your chance to have found a winner. But if we zoom in a little closer to the chart, we can see that it is starting to level up. The lows are starting to rise. It has broken above the recent resistance, and it is holding above this 8-period exponential moving average. This stock is only about 81 cents at the moment, so it's a very nice low price stock. It has gotten above all of these moving averages. So as far as I'm concerned, all the boxes are checked on this one, and I just think this one is setting up to be a potentially fantastic trade, maybe even a fantastic long-term hold, because that base is looking super constructive for a long-term move if this thing does get going. But I just want to show you LKCO because I think it's a great-looking chart. Let's get over to the next one. All right, well, the last one I want to show you is AutoWeb Incorporated, ticker symbol AUTO. This thing had a huge move back in August of last year, and tons of volumes came into this stock, and it has been gyrating back and forth, pulling back a little bit every single month, it seems like. And, you know, this is what I would expect to see out of a stock like TSNP. Once you get a ton of volume that comes into a stock and you get a lot of volatility, it's very unusual to see it just kind of go sideways for over a week. You know, you expect to see these kind of swings back and forth because there's just so many players that are coming into this market. You know, and if you have a relatively calmly sideways trend, then yeah, you're going to get those, you know, many, many days in a row where it basically goes nowhere. But once volatility picks up, you know, you expect a lot of wild swings, and that's what attracts swing traders like myself that try to capture these moves. But I just wanted to point this stock out because it probably looks like what TSNP should look like and what TSNP could look like once volatility and volume starts jumping back into that stock. But anyway, getting back to auto, if you were wanting to enter this stock, I think now is a pretty good time because it looks like it is starting to carve out a bottom here. You know, if I zoom in a little closer, we can draw all kinds of trend lines that are starting to form. This thing is carving out a lot of support and resistance levels. And I think once this compresses maybe just a little bit farther, we should get a breakout to the upside. I'm guessing it's probably going to break to the upside, but it could break to the downside because it has been trending down since September. But usually when stocks scream up like this, they'll trend down for a few months. It'll get kind of quiet, you know, and then a lot of the short-term traders like myself will get bored and move on. But actually, this is when you should be getting a little more excited about the stock because this is setting up for another fast move up. I'm guessing we are going to get another move up because this trend has been kind of weak. It's been kind of a creeping trend to the downside. So normally when you get a fast move in one direction followed by a creeping trend, you get another fast move coming out of that creeping trend in the same direction that it went into it. So AutoWeb, I think, is looking really interesting for this next week or two. It might not break out for a couple of weeks, but it's definitely worth putting on your watch list to see when it breaks out of this pattern, because that should lead to a pretty decent move one way or the other. All right, everybody, that is all I have for you today, so I'm going to end the video right there. If you have any questions or comments on any of these stocks, please leave them down there in the comments section, and I will get back to you as soon as I can. Please like the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already so you don't miss any future trading or investing ideas. Thank you so much for watching my video all the way to the end, and until next time, take care, everybody.